The weather component we're going to take a look at today is air pressure. And we're going to find out what air pressure has to do with determining the weather we have on a day-to-day basis. You're going to take the notes on air pressure on the second page at the top of the second page of your note packet about air pressure. Again, if I go too fast, feel free to stop this at any time or back up to make sure that you get all the information that you need. Okay, here we go. The definition of air pressure is the weight of all of the atmosphere above us pushing down. It's measured with a barometer, and the average air pressure is 14 pounds per square inch. So you take a square inch of your body, and there's almost 15 pounds of pressure on that. You multiply it by your whole body. And that's actually quite a bit of air pressure pushing down on us. But we have become accustomed to that over time. It's just what we're used to. But you do notice the air pressure changing. There is a part of your body that allows you to know that the air pressure is changing. And it is the part of your body that is the weakest at resisting air pressure change, and that is your eardrums. And so if you go up in elevation or down in elevation, your ears will pop, and that's your eardrums adjusting that pressure, that change in pressure. We have relative terms for air pressure. We can say it's high air pressure or low air pressure, and we'll get into what that means in a little bit. And then what we're really trying to understand is, what does air pressure have to do with weather? And really, it's decreasing air pressure. It's important for us to understand, which decreasing would mean getting lower. And there are lots of things that can decrease the air pressure. We can increase the elevation. If you go up in elevation, that means there's less atmosphere above you, so the pressure is less. You can increase the humidity because water actually weighs less than air. You can increase the temperature, which will cause air to expand, and so there's less air above you. And all of three of these will make the air less dense and cause it to rise. So we're going to talk about what high and low pressure do or how they create the type of weather that we see. This is kind of the key part of understanding about air pressure and what we're talking about today. So we base our predictions on air pressure on what's happening with the air pressure itself. Okay, so if the air pressure is increasing, that means there's more pressure. So the air is denser and it's less likely to rise. That means we're going to have fair weather, better weather, cooler air, clear skies, dry. And that's because air is not rising. When air rises, it can cool. And when it cools, it can lose the moisture in it. It can cause condensation in clouds and things like that. And so we want air that is stable, that's not moving upward. And that happens in a high pressure system. If you ever look at a weather map, that's the H's on the weather map. You want an H over where you live, unless you like rain. And then decreasing pressure or low pressure, you're going to have warmer, poorer weather, and humid air, and cloudy skies, and precipitation and storms. So in other words, high pressure is good weather, low pressure is bad weather. All right, in your assignment today, you're going to take a look at air pressure and what that has to do with weather. So you're going to be looking at different areas of air pressure, high and low pressure, trying to read that on maps and interpreting what that will do to the weather. Good luck with that.